Hi friends, Father Ron here. Tomorrow, Thanksgiving, we're going to have a God Minute prayer, but Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, we won't be gathering in prayer, but we'll be back on Monday. From our chapel in St. Louis, Missouri, I'm Father Ron Hoy. Thanks for joining us. This is the God Minute Random Wednesday. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips,
and my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 129. They have pressed me hard from my youth. Let Israel sing. They have pressed me hard from my youth, but could never overcome me.
The plowman plowed my back, drawing long furrows. Yet the Lord, who is just, has destroyed the yoke of the wicked.
Let them be shamed and routed, all those who hate Zion. Let them be like grass on the roof that withers before it flowers.
With that, no reaper fills his hands, no binder of sheaves his arms, and those passing by will not say, "The blessing of the Lord be upon you." We bless you in the name of the Lord.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
Walking the Camino, Six Ways to Santiago, my Wednesday reflection. Many of you may have heard of the very famous Martin Sheen film about the Camino de Santiago called The Way. It is definitely entertaining, it tugs at the heartstrings, and you are given some amazing views and insights into a Catholic pilgrimage that goes back nearly 1,200 years across northern Spain. The movie also leaves a lot out. Similar to life, a pilgrimage drops you smack dab into the middle of real life with real people from hundreds of different places. Some are religious on the Camino, but many are not. Some are very thoughtful, while others are just plain annoying. For whatever reason, they are there, though, walking the Camino, walking in the same footsteps as Francis of Assisi, Teresa of Avila, or Ignatius of Loyola. In the ancient world and later in the Low and High Middle Ages, Spain was considered the end of the world, the westernmost tip of Europe. Jesus had commanded believers to go to the end of the world and preach the good news, and so they literally did, and a pilgrimage was born. A better film, I think, is called Walking the Camino, Six Ways to Santiago. It is a really excellent documentary that features six different pilgrims from many places walking for many different reasons along the route. They are real people, and some of them are very likable, while others are not. Some seem to be thinking deeply about their lives, while others simply aren't. In other words, the film invites us into a world that we pretty much walk each day of our life, whether on official pilgrimage or just walking the pilgrimage that is life. It seems to me that God loves the ordinary, the real, the day-to-day. Think about it. Jesus became one of us in all ways but sin, in order to share and embrace our human condition, to feel it, hear it, know it. Jesus is such a believable Savior because he really and truly knows what it's like to be one of us. Because of the Martin Sheen movie, The Way, the Camino de Santiago became very popular. There are all types of ways to walk the Camino. You can walk it very simply, staying in rough dormitories along the route, or by booking luxury manor homes with lovely meals. Again, similar to life in a way, I think that walking the Camino, Six Ways to Santiago, invites most of us into the life we already recognize. Life is not a vacation. It's not a once-off experience. It is trying to be what God has created us to be, find those who can help us do this, and find who we can help, simply looking for the smallest graces in the most ordinary of things. Now, granted, no one I know would necessarily describe me as normal, but that being said, by God's grace, we are all exactly what we are as God created us. The Camino reminds me of this. And hopefully you have your own examples of how normal, how ordinary God can really be.
And as Jesus taught us, we pray,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. O Lord, let my one goal in life be your kingdom, both here on earth and in the life to come. May I recognize that the only sure means to that goal is my cooperation with your grace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
That's it for today, folks. Thanks for being with us. I know you're busy, probably getting ready for the big turkey day. Family, friends, good love, lots to be grateful for, no doubt. And I'm thankful for you for being with us today. Let's pray for each other. God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow.